previous session, we have covered five functions related to our NumPy arrays. In our today's session, we will be starting with a new topic in NumPy arrays, that is indexing. First of all, let's understand what is indexing. To understand indexing with our NumPy arrays, I'll create an array over here which has some elements, let's say 1, 7, 8, 3, 12. Okay, this is my array. And if I want to provide it with the indexing, that means I want to give it a position number. So computer, what computer does, basically indexing means that computer provides a position to each number, each element inside anything, whether it's a list, a tuple, or an array. Okay, so here also it provides it with a position over here. So here 1 will be on position number 0, 7 will be on position number 1, 8 will be on position number 2, 3 will be on position number 3, and 12 will be on position number 4. That means the indexing over here, this is called as positive indexing. So positive indexing starts from number 0 and goes up to whatever numbers, whatever elements are there inside our array. And if I talk about the negative indexing at the same time, negative indexing, that means the negative indexing is the one which starts from the left. So negative indexing always starts from minus 1, then minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, and minus 5. In this way, these elements are given indexes based on negative format. Okay. So this one is called as negative indexing. So we have two types of indexing, positive indexing and negative indexing. We mainly focus or majorly focus on positive indexing only. So here also in this session, we'll be focusing on positive indexing, while at the same time, we can use negative indexing as well. Now, how the positive indexing works, how you can call for an element. Suppose if this is an array, the name of the array is ARR. So you can call it by writing ARR, and in the square bracket, you can provide it with its position. Suppose if I'll write 2, in the output, I will receive the element which is there on number 2, that is 8 over here. Similarly, if I would have written ARR and here inside it, I would have written 3. So on third position, we have, that means on fourth position. So 0, 1, 2, 3, on third index, on number 3 index, we have our fourth element, that is 3. So this is how basically indexing work in one dimension. But what if we are talking about two dimension? In that case, there is a little bit changing in the indexing. Let's understand and see what is that. So suppose if I have two arrays over here, a two-dimensional array if I have, we have 2, 3, 7 and 8. And then we have another array over here, that is 4, 6, 6, 5. Okay. Now what do I need to do? I need to obtain, let's say 7. To obtain 7 using the indexing, what we can do, we can write ARR. ARR is the name of this array. So I'll be just writing it as ARR. ARR and the square bracket, what we will do, first of all, we will talk about the indexing of this whole array. So these two arrays has two different indexes. So this array will be on index number 0 and this index will be on number 1. Okay, so first of all, we will go inside 0 because we need to fetch the element which is in our index number 0. So we'll be writing 0, comma, and inside this we are going for 0, 1, 2, 3. So we want the number which is on position number 2. So if we write it in this way, if we write 0, that from the 0 array, we need to find the second position, that whatever value is there on our position number 2, index number 2. In that way, we will obtain 7 over here. Similarly, if I talk about the second array over here and I want to obtain this number 5 here. In that case, what I will do, I'll go and write ARR. Over here, I'll be writing that it belongs to our array number 1, the array which is on position number 1. And then inside it, we'll be checking for this is on number 0, this is on number 1, this is on number 2, and this is on number 3. So we'll be going for number 3, and in that way, we will obtain 5 over here. Now let's apply the same method on our PyCharm and let's see if it works for us or not. So first thing over here we need to do is we need to import NumPy, importing NumPy as NP. Once we have imported NumPy as NP, I'll be creating an array over here. For array, I'll be writing ARR is equals to np.array. And here I'll be passing a list of elements. Let's say we'll start with 1D first of all. So I'll be giving some elements over here. Okay. Now what do I need to do? If I want to obtain number 5, this number 5 over here, in that case I'll be writing print ARR. And in the square bracket, so this one, the first one is on 0. Then the second value is on 1. Third value is on number 2. So I'll be writing number 2 over here. And as soon as I run it, I'll get the output as 5. That is the element that we wanted to obtain. Similarly, if I want to obtain this, let's say number 4. For this, we'll be checking 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's on 4. And if I'll write 4 over here and run it, I'll be getting the output as 4. That on 0, we have 5. Then 1, we have 2. On 2, we have 5. On 3, we have 8. And on number 4, we have number 4 itself. Okay, this is our one day indexing. Now let's move ahead and talk about our 2D indexing. For 2D indexing, I'll just reduce the number of elements in this one and I'll be adding another array over here. So, okay, this is my second array here, and to make it 2D, I'll be adding another pair of square brackets. Now, what do I need to do if I talk about, let's say I want to obtain number 5 of our second array. So for our second array, this array is on number 0 and this array is on number 1. So we'll be going to our number 1 array, I'll put a comma, and inside this we want to obtain number 5, which is on again number 1. So if I run it now, I'll be getting 5. Okay, the dimensions are not matching because there are 5 elements in the first array and again there are 6 elements. So now if I run it, I'll be getting the output as 5 here. Similarly, if I want to obtain 8, this 8, if I want to obtain this 8 over here, so it is in our array number 1, that means the array which is on our position number 1, and inside it we'll be going for 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So on number 4 we have 8, so we'll be writing 4 here, and as soon as we run it, we'll get the output as 8. Similarly, if you want to obtain number 4, this number 4 from our first array, for that we'll be going to our position as 0, because this array belongs to position 0, and here 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So on fourth number we have it. So again, if I run it, I'll get the output 4 over here. Similarly, if I would have written 3 over here, in that case I would have received 8 as an output. So this is how an indexing can be done in our 2D arrays. Now let's move ahead and talk about 3D arrays over here. For 3D, what I'll be doing, I'll be creating a pair of 2-2 arrays. So now I have created a 3-dimensional array. Let's understand how indexing will work in our 3-dimensional array. So for example, the way I have created it is like this, that I have 2, 3 here and 4, 5 here. Also 2, 8 here. And 3, 6 here. This will be 2D array. But what if I join one more bracket over here, and I'll enclose this inside this, and I'll enclose this inside this. So now what do we need to do? We need to go. Suppose if I want to find the position of this element, in that case, what I will be doing. First of all, we will be talking about this whole one bracket. So this will be on number 0, and this whole one bracket, the set of this bracket, will be on number 1. Inside this, I need to go on these individual arrays. So this one is on number 0, this one is on number 1, this one is on number 0, and this one is on number 1. Now inside these also, this element is on number 0, this element is on number 1, this element is on number 0, and this element is on number 1. So what I'll be doing, for fetching 4 over here, I'll be writing ARR. Inside this, we are going inside the first array over here, we will be writing 0, comma. The second thing is, between which array we need to find out. So here, the second thing over here is between which array we need to find out. So over here we need to find out from this array. This array is on index number 1. And lastly, inside this array, we are talking about element number 0, that is 4. So I'll be writing 0, 1, 0. In that way, I will obtain 4 over here. Similarly, if I talk about obtaining 8 of this array, in that case, what I'll be doing, I'll be again writing ARR. And because we are going in our second array, so we'll be writing 1. Inside the second array, we are talking about our first array. The element is inside our first array, that is number 0. And inside this, we have two values, 2 and 8. So 2 is on number 0 and 8 is on number 1. So here I'll be writing number 1. In that way, I will obtain 8 as a value. Let's have a look. Let's apply the same method inside our PyCharm and let's see if it is working for us or not. So let's say I need to obtain this number 5. For number 5, we are going in this set of array is on number 1. I'll put a comma, and then here we are going inside this set of array, which is in both of them, in 2, 5 and 7, 8. 2, 5 is on number 0, comma, and in number 2 and number 5, the number 5 is on second position, that means on number 1. So as soon as I run it here, I should be getting the output as 5, and yes, I'm getting the output as 5, that means it's working perfectly fine. Similarly, if I talk about the first element over here, if I want to obtain this 5 over here, in that case, what I will do, so this 5, this is inside our first array, that means first array, the indexing of first array is 0. Inside our first array, we are talking about 5, 2 and 8, 4. We have two arrays, 5, 2 and 8, 4. So the index number of this array would be 1. Sorry, so the index number of this array would be 0. Again, I'll put a comma. Now if I talk about 5 and 2. So between 5 and 2, 5 will be on 0 and 2 will be on 1. So again, I'll write 0, and as soon as I run it, I'll get the output 5 again. Similarly, instead of 0, if I would have written 1 over here, in that case, I would have received 2. Because 2 is the second element inside this array. So this is how indexing in our 3-dimensional array works over here. So I hope guys that it is clear how indexing works in our 1-dimensional array, 2-dimensional array and 3-dimensional array. In our next session, we'll be talking about iteration in our NumPy array. So stay connected guys and I'll see you in the next session. Thank you.